Hello friends, welcome back to this video on analog communication. In this video, I am going to talk about the single tone modulation of DSB-SE type of amplitude modulation. I have already discussed about DSB-SE type of amplitude modulation in my previous videos. So I hope you remember what is single tone modulation. So if I talk about the single tone modulation, I have the XT. XT represents my input signal. The input signal is the function of only one frequency. So it has only one frequency component. So I am representing XT as AM cos omega MT. So I hope you remember how I used to represent the carrier. Carrier was represented using AC cos of omega CT. So now if I talk about MT, MT is the modulated signal. So MT is equal to XT into CT. So MT would be XT into CT. So I'll multiply XT and CT. So XT is AM cos of omega MT into AC cos of omega CT. So I can write it like AM into AC upon 2 into 2 cos omega MT into cos omega CT. So now this formula becomes 2 cos A cos B. So 2 cos A cos B has the formula AM AC by 2. So this 2 cos A cos B would be cos of A plus B. So I am taking this to be A. So it would be omega C plus omega M into T plus cos of A minus B. So it would be cos of omega C minus omega M into T. So now this represents my MT. So MT is having this form. So now if I talk about the received signal. So the received signal, I hope you remember the received signal. How can I find out? The reception in double sideband suppressed carrier is only of synchronous type. So in synchronous type, I'll multiply MT again with CT. So when MT is multiplied with CT, so MT was AM AC cos omega MT into cos omega CT. It is again multiplied with cos of omega CT. So here I'll get AM AC cos omega MT into cos square omega CT. So I am not taking any error. The locally generated carrier is having the same frequency as the carrier in the transmitter. So RT can be written down as AM into AC cos omega MT. So this cos square omega CT can be written as 1 plus cos 2 omega CT upon 2. So now I can expand this equation and I can write it equal to AM AC upon 2 cos omega MT plus again AM AC upon 2 cos omega MT cos 2 omega CT. So again this is also cos A cos B. So again I can write down it like AM AC upon 2 cos omega MT plus this is cos 2 cos A cos B. So for 2 cos A cos B, I'll divide by 2. So AM AC upon 4 into 2 cos A cos B will become cos of A plus B. So A is this. So 2 omega C plus omega M into T plus cos of 2 omega C minus omega M into T. So this is my RT. So now I'll pass it through the low pass filter. So when I'll pass it through the low pass filter, this equation and this equation will get cancelled out because it's the high frequency carrier. So here I have high frequency component cos of 2 omega plus something and here also cos of 2 omega minus something. So these are high frequency carrier which are rejected in the receiver during the low pass filter. So now here I am getting the reception RT equal to AM AC upon 2 into cos of omega MT. So now You can see from here, this AM into cos of omega MT represents my XT. So this RT is representing my input signal with AC and 2 are constant. So we can normalize it and I can find out my input signal. So this is how I can detect and transmit. We can transmit my MT, the single tone amplitude modulated signal. So here I can receive the single tone amplitude modulated signal using DSP-SC. So now talking about the frequency spectrum analysis. So now if I talk about the frequency spectrum, let the frequency spectrum of x of t would be x of omega. So when I talk about x of omega, x of t is am cos omega mt. So I can easily find out x of omega. So am is a constant and I know the Fourier transform of cos of omega. So it would be am into pi del of omega minus omega m plus del of omega plus omega m. So now if I represent it graphically, so here at minus omega m and plus omega m, I have impulse of length am into pi. So this represents the frequency spectrum of x of omega. So now talking about the frequency spectrum of m of t. So m of omega would be, I can find the Fourier transform of this equation. So m of omega would be am AC by 2. So cos of omega plus omega C plus omega M, I have the frequency. So I'll be taking del of omega minus this full frequency omega C plus omega M plus del of omega plus this full frequency again omega C plus omega M. So now after that plus I have cos of omega C minus omega MT. Again, I'll be having del omega minus omega C minus omega M plus del omega plus omega C minus omega M. So I have four impulse functions here. So if I represent it graphically, so here I have first function at omega C plus omega M. The second function at minus omega C plus omega M. The third function is at omega C minus omega M. And the fourth at minus omega C minus omega M. So now this represents the frequency spectrum of my modulated signal. And the amplitude of these functions would be, so these are impulse functions with the amplitude is same, which is am ac pi upon 2. So now talking about the frequency spectrum of RT. So now R of omega. So R of omega would contain a lot of terms. So it would be am ac upon 2 cos of omega mt. So it would be pi del of omega minus omega m plus del omega plus omega m. So now the next term is am ac by 4. So I'll be adding am ac by 4. So here I have cos of 2 omega c plus omega m. So it would be pi del of omega minus 2 omega c plus omega m plus del of omega plus 2 omega C plus omega M. So now after that this term is added. So for that I have amplitude again AM AC upon 4 pi del omega minus, this frequency is omega C minus omega M plus del omega plus omega C minus omega M. So now if I talk about the graph, so here I am representing the omega, the amplitude here would be am ac pi upon 2, it is at omega m and minus omega m. So here I have omega m, here minus omega m. So here the amplitude is am ac pi upon 2. So this represents my these two signals. So after that I have the impulse function at 2 omega c plus omega m. So this is 2 omega c plus omega m. Here I have impulse function of the length half of this length. So this is am ac by 4 pi. So again the next is at omega plus 2 omega c plus omega m. So it is at minus omega minus 2 omega c minus 2 omega c plus omega m. So here again I have an impulse function of the same length as this. So am ac pi upon 4. So now the next impulse is at omega c minus 2 omega c minus omega m and 2 omega c plus minus 2 omega c minus omega m and plus 2 omega c minus omega m. So if I talk about minus 2 omega c minus omega m and 2 omega c minus omega m. So here also I have the impulse of the same length. Here also impulse is having the same length. So now I hope you can see when I pass this through the low pass filter, these are high frequency components. So these will get rejected with the help of low pass filter. And I'll get this component only which represents the two side bands. So here I have upper side band as well as lower side band of my message signal. So this is why it is called double side band. So in all of the cases which I discussed till now, I have double side band. So I have two side bands, the upper and the lower, of two upper and two lower side bands. So it is called double side band suppressed carrier. I don't have any carrier here. So again, I hope you understood the single tone amplitude modulation. I discussed the relationship in the time domain and the frequency domain of single tone amplitude modulation. Now you can represent the amplitude modulation of DSB SC in multi-tone amplitude modulation as well. So for that you can take here different frequency components. So I can take XT equal to A1 cos omega 1T plus A2 cos omega 2T for multi-tone amplitude modulation. So now for that same things will happen, only I have here four impulse functions. Here I'll be having, so you can find out how many impulse function here I'll be having double of impulse function in every scenario. So you can find out, you can hit and trial with this formula to find out the amplitude modulation in DSB SC of multi-tone amplitude modulation. So if you have any doubt, you can put the doubt, and if you still have any doubt for multi-tone amplitude modulation, I'll derive it for multi-tone amplitude modulation as well. But I hope you will try it yourself first. I hope you understood each and everything which I discussed here, because I am winding up the session here. I hope you like this video. If you like it, share it with your friends, subscribe to the channel and push the like button. Thank you.